by popular demand, I have received the request to make pan de campo. Does popular demand mean I'm popular? Probably not. And so, pan de campo is a type of bread that is made on the ranches around South Texas, and it was usually made during the roundup. You could take a large pot with you and some dough and bake your pan de campo on site. It's really delicious, especially because we have mesquite wood here in South Texas, so the bread gets this really gorgeous mesquite flavor. It is super good. It's not really a tricky recipe. It's really just like a big old biscuit, but the way that you bake it, now that's the tricky part. So if you're a little nervous about making it out in the field, try making it at home first. It's flour, shortening, vegetable oil, sugar, and a little bit of milk. Oh, and don't forget the salt. Once you have your ingredients mixed together, it's time to roll it out. You need to roll it out to about a half inch thickness, about 9 to 12 inches in diameter. Place it on parchment paper and pop it in the oven for about 20 minutes. Now, when you get out in the field, it's a completely different story. There are so many variables when you are cooking outdoors. So if you can manage to make the dough at home, then the only variables that you need to worry about when you're out in the field are, is the wind blowing? Is it raining? Do you have enough firewood? Can you start a fire? Are your friends drinking? That's chaos. Do you have somebody to help you? Making pan de campo is a lot easier if you have a team, because managing a fire takes some extra tools and a little bit of extra muscle. I had my friends Michaela and Miguel stop by, and they helped me make my pan de campo. Michaela and I got the fire started, but we had to wait a little bit before the embers burned down and they were the proper temperature for making our pan de campo. We have a 14-inch Dutch oven, and we really are using it as an oven. So the mesquite embers are going to be piled underneath and over the Dutch oven, so we have this wonderful warm oven environment. One of the cool things that we discovered when we were making pan de campo was if we put more coals on the top than underneath, we didn't need to flip it at all. Flipping the pan de campo can be really challenging because the Dutch oven is usually about 400 to 500 degrees and it has embers on top of the lid. It's crazy. So you really don't want to disturb it too much. If you don't have enough fire, you may need to flip it, but we found that after about 10 minutes of baking with extra coals on top, it was beautifully baked with no flipping at all. Once our beautiful pan de campo was baked, we served it up with some ranch honey that Miguel brought, and it was spectacular. I ate way too much, but I didn't eat enough. Check out the recipe on my blog. It's kitchenwrangler.com. And if you have any recipe requests, you know you can reach out to me at help@kitchenwrangler.com or follow me on Instagram or Facebook. Make sure you smash that subscribe button and follow me on YouTube for more cooking adventures here in South Texas. I'm Melissa Guerra. I am the Kitchen Wrangler, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here at the ranch again real soon. Bye now.